Hey, folks, this is Ben, and lately I've gotten several emails on the same thing or same type of thing. They want to know about menu pricing, how much money they'll make per hot dog, how to mark up a hot dog, how do you know how much is too much, how much is too little, what's the profits overall, and all the other individual items. And over in my course book, Hot Dog Save My Life, you can Google that, Hot Dog Save My Life, you can get that book. And it covers it in great detail. I even have it broke down for you. But I'm going to share something awesome with you here. At the end of this, you'll have access to the entire chapter 10 of that book, which itemizes everything down all the way to the propane per serving. So I go over this in great detail on the Street Food Vendor blog too. If you go to learnhotdogs.com, and this applies to all vendors, no matter what you're serving in the food industry, this will work. But we deal mostly with hot dog vendors and caterers, and so they often ask, how do I figure my pricing? And I'm going to cover that very thoroughly for you and give you an idea, plus give you some simple steps and tips so that you can get there quickly. I have many articles that deal with pricing and profits, but it's about time that I updated some of this with newer information and share that information with you. The best thing is you want to set up your pricing for the best profits while keeping customers coming back for more. In this video, I will not be discussing the plethora of menu options because I have tons of training on that over at learnhotdogs.com, and you can watch and read them all by just searching the word menu in the search box. Now, let's get on with this. And remember that over on the training blog, I'll have a detailed and itemized breakdown for you and a link so you can download chapter 10 for free of my course book, which will cover the menu selection along with tons of other tips and advice and the breakdown. Worst case scenario, let's say you're as broke as a convict. Okay, I mean, you have little to no money like I was when I first started, and you can't buy in bulk. You have to go to the grocery store and buy packs of hot dogs. Okay, and you grab several packs maybe, or two or three packs to get started. As long as you can go back and get more, you're fine. So I found these recently for a common brand, a national brand. I'm not suggesting the brand, but I like this brand. You can get these Oscar Mayer dogs for about $2.50 a pack. Now in this one, these are called 10 to ones because there's 10 hot dogs per pack. And pretty easy, huh? And are 10 dogs to a pound is what I mean, not per pack. So you could go get a 8 to 1s is the most common, 8 to a pound, 8 dogs to a pound. You can also go get a 4 to 1, which is a quarter pound hot dog. But what I advise you to do is always have an 8 to 1. That's the most common size. That's what most people sell them in. Now, some of the manufacturers are coming out with these 10 packs so they can say, oh, 10 dogs compared to 8 dogs. Well, it's still a pound of hot dog. So you can take that for what it's worth. So let's do some simple math. You can buy these for about $2.50 anywhere in the country. Sometimes you can find them at $2. Usually if you just look around on different competing grocery store chains, they'll have them opposite weeks for less. So you might get it for $2.25 or even $2. So we're going to do the simple math, and we go, okay, I paid $2.50 for 10 hot dogs. That's 25 cents a dog, right? Well, that's not your entire food cost. There's more, right? There's that you already have the hot dog. You got buns, relish, onions, ketchup, mustard, mayonnaise, chips, drinks, napkins, full sheets, ice, and propane. So you have all this other stuff that you have to consider as part of your cost. It's a consumable, and it goes into the cost. You cannot exclude these things. They all have a cost, and if you download the itemized list I've made for you over on the blog, the link will be below the video, you'll see that even propane can be cost out per serving. So I've gotten real detailed with this for you to make this as easy as possible so that you know some real costs. Now, you're probably wondering why I include the drinks and chips, okay? Drinks and chips I include because most vendors are selling a meal deal, a value meal, okay? So individually, a hot dog may be $3 on your cart. And in my case, my value meal is 2 hot dogs, a bag of chips, and a drink. They are actually getting, when you figure it up, they're getting the dogs for $2 a piece now, or even $2.50 a piece, depending on what price I put on that value meal. So value meals increase your ticket size per customer. And don't worry, I'm fixing to go back over that. So if you were a little confused by that, I'm going to cover it again here just shortly. So Value meals increase your ticket size per customer and are a great way to make more while giving a great value and building repeat customers. Okay. After it's all said and done, you may have more condiments, better condiments than in my example, but bottom line is I average about $1.50 a meal cost. Okay. Two dogs, chips, and a can soda. Depending on my bulk purchases, that may be as high as $2 for the meal and as low as $1.20 for the meal, depending on what I got deals on. If you sell a specialty hot dog, let's say a Vienna or a Sabretz or one of these, some of those hot dogs can run as high as 80 cents a piece, your cost. And that's with nothing added. That's just the dog. Okay. So for the sake of this example, I'm going to stay with what closely falls in line with most vendors. We will use the $1.40 a meal average. Okay. So industry standard says food cost should be about 35% of your sales price. So this would put you around $5 for the meal. Now, how I got that is you take your food cost, okay, of $1.40, multiply that times 3.5, will give you the $5 roughly. It actually gives you about $4.50 or something, but you'll end up round up. So some of my friends, these pro vendors out there, will price around 20 to 25%. They want their food cost at about 20 to 25%. Well, at 20%, you're looking at five times. So whatever their food cost is, they multiply it times five, and that's their sale price. Now, you may have to fluctuate that a little bit because sometimes it'll come out with an odd number, like 518. Well, no, don't do that. Go to five or go to six, but don't be at 550. Dealing with change is a pain in the neck. So you could price each hot dog at $3 each individually, and then soda at $1 and chips at $1, and that would be two hot dogs for $3, chips and soda would put you at $8 for the meal. But you give them a discount because it's a value meal. So if they were buying it individually, or what they call a la carte, they on a hot dog cart, a la hot dog cart, you would end up with an $8 price. But because it's a meal deal, you can give it to them for $7, or you give it to them for $6, or whatever you feel like you want to do, and depending on your food costs. Again, a simple rule, add up your food cost and then multiply it times 4 is a safe, really safe bet. That puts your food cost at about 25%. It is not that common that we all get 25%. Most restaurants operate at about 35% because they have a lot more overhead to factor in. You shouldn't have all that. You should be able to get this down to 25, 30% and be picking in high cotton. Okay. So this doesn't mean, okay, that you can go get a $1.12 hot dog, a hot dog that cost you $1.12, mark it up four times and be at $4.48, okay? Because you may not get that. Your market area may not be able to afford that, the people you're marketing to. So you always want to buy and price to the market you work. So if you work, you know, we've had a vendor on the show one time and we put up pictures of his cart and everything, and his cart is dilapidated, and he made it sexy by putting it on a lawnmower cart, and he dressed it up with siding and everything, and it looks cool. But he's in a poor area and people like $1 hot dogs. Okay. They'd rather get $1 hot dog. And so he has to buy right and sell right in order to stay in business. Now if you're downtown, PA maybe, or Washington DC, you might be able to get $4 or $5 for a dog. You had a winery or at a ski slope, you may be able to get a $7-$8 for a dog. It just depends on where you are. So say you're like, Jason at, Street Food Pro. He sells exotic meat hot dogs, you know, like rabbit dogs and crocodile and stuff like that. Well, he may pay $2 for one and can sell that for $8, okay? Easily, he can sell it. But I can't get $8 for a hot dog in front of the Tractor Supply or the Piggly Wiggly. If you keep your food cost 25%, you're going to be great. 30%, great. 35, you're right on the edge. Always be working to get that lower. Don't scrimp, though. I want you to not scrimp ever. Please don't scrimp. I see vendors out there, and I've had vendors send me pictures, and I see these no-name chips and these off-brand sodas. Never, never, never scrimp there. You can buy no-name hot dogs as long as they're quality meats, all beef, whatever you decide to go with. You can do that and name them your own name, And when people ask what kind of hot dog that is or what brand it is, say, like, we got Hot Dog Mike. He goes, these are Hot Dog Mike dogs, or they're Hillbilly Hot Dogs. They're our dogs. So that's what you do. You can flavor the water, season the water, and make them your own hot dog. So don't scrimp, though, on your soda and your chips. It will hurt you more than you think, and it looks crappy. So it's like going to a hotel and they have the horrible toilet paper, and then you go to one that has the good toilet paper. I'd rather pay more and get the good toilet paper. So I'll have more for you over on the blog, and we'll talk about whether you should have add-ons, upsells, upcharges, or you shouldn't. Should I include chili and cheese or should I not? Should it be an upsell? Should I charge them a dollar for it? I'm going to go over that with you over on the blog, and I'll have the link right down below. If you have any questions or anything, please comment over on the blog, and I'll try to get them answered as fast as possible. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you have a wonderful day.